guys can watch me take off. Hopefully it'll go smoothly. I got a little bit of a quartering wind off my starboard side, and but I've got that counteracted a little bit with the motor. Should be fine. But I'm deciding to move along instead of trying to go up, hike up the mountain today and fly. There's just a little bit too much breeze. Better to move up the lake with the conditions not so bad. It's supposed to be better tomorrow, so that'll be a little more conducive for flying and some hiking. So here we go. As you can see, I released the downwind guy and bow line first, and then do the one that's tensioned upwind. We're good. And we'll back away here and this is the area map of Lake Temagami, and you'll see in the north arm there, the route for today is in orange, the track I should say, and it goes from Devil's Mountain boat site up through Ferguson Bay into Sandy Inlet to the Ferguson Mountain boat site, where I'll be stopped for the day. And this is another map showing the marine chart with the depths going from Devil's Mountain up to Ferguson Mountain. Now the track there is in yellow. This is Jeff's map showing the detail of the area, the trails, and where the campsites are. The boat site I'm using there, you can see the arrow pointing toward. And then tomorrow I'm planning to pick up the trail at the where the stream comes into the lake. There's from that Copper Sand Lake. You can see over on the left side is a pair of field glasses. That's the overlook. That'll be the plan for tomorrow. Wind is out a little bit out of the northwest. You can see I'm skirting the shoreline. And there's a buoy coming up. The green up ahead there, you can see that on the chart. And I'm going to try to go just as close as I can to that. Stay in deep water to avoid the wind that's slowing me down going this direction. Kind of beating against it, so you can see on the speed I'm only doing about 3.1 knots. And normally with this RPM, I'd be doing about 3.8, 3.9. You'll be able to see the buoy coming up here pretty quick. Got to kind of think about the winds all the time, because it's a big hulk with only a 9.9 Yamaha on the back, so it's kind of a gutless wonder. But it gets around, slow but sure. And the only thing is, I wouldn't want to go too much stronger in the wind. This is probably 10, with occasional gusts to 12 to 15 even. But kind of a limit. Maybe you could go a little higher, but you're going to slow way down and not make much speed. We'll give this buoy just a little wider berth here. I don't want to get caught up in the shoals, although it should be accurate. They wouldn't put a buoy down if they weren't being careful about where it's placed. But you'll just see it coming up on the left here shortly. The island is off to the left there, and you can see the reef that it's marking. Now, there's a pretty good chunks of rock coming out there from the land. So we'll just stay well clear of it there. The buoy's showing up there now in the picture. And you can see the little better shot of the reef that it's keeping you away from. Open to the right, there's a little device here on the helm station that kind of a little guidance tool that you turn around whether you're going outbound or inbound, and to mark which side the buoy should be on. Although it's fairly obvious if you look at the chart, the reef is on the other side of that green buoy, so that means you want to keep that buoy to your left going outbound. This seems to be helping a little bit. The wind is quieter on this side of the, and I'm going to sneak in a little bit closer here in this little bay. Instead of going directly for the point you can see there, I'm going to go into the bay a little bit to keep out of the wind as much as possible. Double checking to make sure there's no shoals or reefs.
Her right eyeball was so close to the ice, she could see crystals moving by in fits and starts. The endless embrace of the lake was being scraped off. A machine gun battered through her head. Her teeth were chattering. Anna had been caught by a bear. Too bad. Bears ate their fish raw.
Are you alive?
Okay, we're kind of entering Ferguson Bay here off to the right. You'll see Mount Ferguson, that's higher terrain off to the right. I'm hoping to do some drone flying and perhaps some hiking around the trail later on if I can. I'm looking for a campsite on the north side of this bay, which is called Sandy Inlet. I just saw two boats Leisure Houseboats coming down from the north, so there were some people up here before. The wind has backed off a little bit. It seems like it's switching more northeast, which is what I expected. So we'll see how the rest of the afternoon goes. The sun is starting to break through in spots, so it's lightening up a little bit. The mist has stopped, and hopefully that means better weather later today. You can see some sunlight on the water behind me there. So things are looking up. It's 67 degrees inside, 54 out, so we got more normal temperatures than what we got last few days. And there's definitely more sunlight around. It's 11 o'clock now. I got off late, about 10:21. So, hoping to get in at a reasonable hour and maybe even do some hiking that today.
Richie, about a quarter of a mile from where you went in. She clicked on her headlamp. Using its light, she began pumping the Coleman lantern. But they were noisy machines, clanking in the preparation and hissing like a thousand angry snakes when lit. Catherine and Bob woke up. "What is it?" Catherine asked, her voice fogged with sleep. "We've trapped a wolf," Robin told her.
Listening to more audiobooks, we're approaching Ferguson Mountain here off to the right. I'm going to head around. I changed my plan. I was going to go up to the north side of this sandy inlet for a campsite. It's a little iffy. It's shown on the Jeff's maps, but it's not shown on the others, so I don't know if it's actually there. Plan was to go there and then maybe kayak over later to for another lookout on that corner of the bay or the inlet.
However, the wind is still blowing pretty good, and it's switching around a little more northeast. So I'm thinking I'll look at Ferguson because tomorrow is supposed to be sunny, and this was kind of a highlight. I wanted to do this particular hike and film some flying around Ferguson. So I'm going to go look at the sights. So it's only 11:20. I'm making good time, so if it doesn't look good, I can always adjust and go the other direction. So that's the current plan. All right, I got the first campsite around the point here on Mount Ferguson. From this distance, it doesn't look too bad, but you probably can barely see it on the camera. We'll get a little closer and maybe you can see. Get a little closer here on this one. Looks like a halfway decent approach, and the wind has dropped a little bit, so I wouldn't be afraid to go in there. It looks like I get a wide enough angle on the guys to make sure I'm secure from the wind. So it's a good alternative. I'll check the next one here and see if it's better. Should be one right around the corner.
No, that is the one on the corner.
That is the one. So, all right. So here's where we're going in, I guess. I missed the other one. There was one actually closer. It wasn't as obvious. This one looks like it should work. So I will give it a try. The problem I can see with it is it's not going to be very good for flying the drone because there's too much tree cover. So I'd have to either go out in the kayak or that wind is going to push me down on this pretty fast. So I got to adjust. Make sure I get the bow around where I want it to be because it's going to crash into the... I'll let it drift from now on in here. But wrong direction. Got to get the stern around there. I want to get over a little further, so the wind is blowing me too much to the right. I don't like that, so I want to make sure I get a wide angle on the bow here. So to do that, I need to be over to the left a little bit more. So I need to come in from that angle. The wind is following the point here a little bit. So it's pushing me sideways as I get in closer. I'll try to gotta really play around with the engines here to I gotta allow for that drift. It's gonna go to the right, so I need to allow for that. And then be ready with the reverse as I approach. I want the stern pulled to the left a little bit. A lot of maneuvering here. Still not quite where I wanted to go, but it'll work. Let's see if it's going to balance. Both hulls now are against the rocks. I'm just going to put slight upwind to hold that stern there. And we'll try this again. No, it's not going to work. The lines are too far away, so back out and try this again. There's a nice clear spot there, but it's too far to the trees for my guy line, so I'm going to move over here. There's more trees off to the left here, and maybe I can get something that will work. Yeah, I'll try this one over here. This looks like a better spot. It's not quite where the wind is a little bit both stern and off to my port side a little bit. So it's wanting to push me to the right. looks like a path over here, and I think this is going to work better for me over here. Got plenty of trees to tie off from. I can get good angles. So we'll go in here, and got to always plan for that drift to the right and anticipate slowing down here and pulling the stern to the left as I do. Okay, we'll just let it go in here. Okay, the pressure is on, so we'll try it again here. Guy was just barely long enough to reach. I'll have to dig out a root over on this side, on the right side, to make that work. But you can see all the jockeying that had to be done to come into this site. Wind is pretty brisk yet out of the northeast. So we'll sign off.